So this morning we are looking at what I call, is there a word from the Lord? What did I say? Is there a word from the Lord? And the first thing is that you know that the word of God can be many dimensions. It can be a logos, but what we are talking about is the rhema part of it. Is the what? The rhema part of it. Logos is general. The word of God, the Bible is, you know, is inspired word of God. It's quick and sharp and powerful. It's a logos, general to everybody. But when it now comes to you directly, that is when it becomes a what? A rhema. It turns your life around. Without, the reason for our progress is because we are hearing from God. And like I said some time ago, I think they put it on the social media, God will never empower what he did not inspire. He will never empower. There will be no grace. There will be struggle and frustration. And the blessings of God maketh rich. And what? Addeth no sorrow. So I want to advocate this morning. I bring this word from God that as you enter the new year, you must be deliberate about hearing from God. It's not a time to play games with your destiny. It's not a period to begin to do trial and error or play all kinds of games and say, let me just try. It's not the season of trying. It's a season of going by what is commanded. Look at somebody, say, by what is commanded. There are so many voices in the air. And the other time I ministered here about strange voices. You saw what happened in Czechoslovakia. I think this week or last week. A boy just had. Something told him to what? To go and kill people. And look, let me tell you something. We are not joking here. What we said just this last week came to pass again. Look at the boy said he had. And how many people did he kill? He just said, so that means that you are not secured if you are traveled, if you don't hear the voice of God. You can travel, say you are going on holiday, and that is the journey to heaven. I tell you, that is the time that we are now. Those people have planned for Christmas, they have planned for, some of them decorated their house, but they never went back to the house. They went from there to heaven straight. I mean, the boy said he had voices. He has, and he's right. Something told him to do it. There are strange voices speaking to people. Look at the youth that was saved. He had something told him to jump inside that river Liffey until some people grab him. And he said, no, I must go there. I must go there. I pray for somebody shouting the loudest amen. Me and you, our children, our family, we shall not hear satanic voice in Jesus' name.